TOMz.
This is my fan, TOMz.
Is in a build.
Hey, bro, how are you, TOMz?
Is in a build.
Yo, my fan, TOMz is in the building indeed. My fan, it's got to 4 p.m. and that can only mean one thing. The best of the best when it comes to sci-tech entertainment is on your screens right about Jenga, man.
Most definitely, and you know how it goes. Your host is your Moses. I go by the name of C-A-D-D-Y, pronounced Caddy. And I'm having you one. I'm with my bro, Usia. My boy, Ugrant.
You're
fresh.
You're awesome.
To another.
You're in.
Anyway, guys, I've got some interesting news. And you're dealing with Usia. Is it good to see you? Anyway, my boy, no more feeling than ipara. Sounds like it's good to eat ipara, a very important insect when it comes to the environment because it keeps the environment together. And it sounds good, there's a whole specialization dedicated to our insects. And even more interesting, there's a sub-specialization about insects and the eating of them.
Definitely, what about you, Bafetu? Let's see what we have in store for you on today's show.
Get it.
Here's what's coming up today on TOMz. I'm going to talk about my insects, but for some, it's deeply rooted in culture. See how mopani worms are made the right way? Now, would like my insects can actually be really good for you. See where this practice actually started out and where will it go in the future? Now, don't keep sitting on the sidelines. Try it yourself with these awesome resources. And if all the insects suddenly died, I got my first feeling of Scotty Food last come now on Facebook and on Twitter. And then I'm trying to get my first feeling of Musuka Shasha. Why are insects important on Earth? Specifically, they're very important. I'm a bees now. I see them in pollination. They're very important. They also help with the fertilization of the soil. Well, guys, keep those comments coming in on Facebook and on Twitter. Facebook.com/TOMz on Twitter. We are simply at TOMz_SABC_1. What am I going to get? I'm insect.
Cool, we still added Bafetu. Namhle Ice Road Show ED Mashabani. Right next to me is a beautiful lady. Ngizombuza my questions. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, and you?
I'm great. What's your name?
Bonyuwe Kunene.
Okay, Bonyuwe, ngifuna ukuyana ne. Ugama ukuthi akhona ama bugs adliwayo la emhlabeni.
No.
Yeah, akhona.
Imaphi?
Amasonja. Ama cockroach. Yeah. Imzimbokane.
Uba nomuntu ke wakutshela ngokuthi ama bugs ayadla.
Like masichede kuphela nabangani bami sicoca bona.
Do you think it's healthy for ukuthi abangani bakho badle ama bugs?
Yeah.
Or anyone?
Like abana bamasonja so somehow are healthy yabo.
Yeah. Yeah, it's healthy.
Why?
Because some people eat them so that they active maka healthy go batho ba ka wash.
Some of them.
When ukewa wadla any bug nje.
Yeah.
Yini le ukewa
amasonja.
Okay, I like to send a shout out to my mom, my dad, my friends, and they were watching TOMz on SABC 1 Zanzi for sure.
Away, make some noise. So guys, ikama leli entomophagy liyenziwe ngalamagama lawo. Into means insects and phagy means to eat. So bahlanganisa it's like eating insects. And then yazi ukuthi every time abantu babazwa lelo gama lelo babalekela igazi. Why? Check this video out.
Now, many ancient civilizations loved eating amabugs and considered them a delicacy. But this all changed when farming evolved. In about 10,000 BC in the Fertile Crescent, a place in the Middle East, agriculture was booming as our nomadic ancestors settled to farm in this fertile land. As they domesticated animals and made small crops, attitudes towards food changed and rippled out to the rest of the world. Manjige, abantu saw insects as things that only destroy their crops and were pests. About 10,000 years ago, hunters and gatherers observed ilwane to see which bugs they ate. Besa nababata lawo, ma bugs lawo. Rich ancient Romans and Greeks loved eating beetle larvae that had been raised on wine. Ama Algerians and Dala nababata would have collected thousands of locusts, then boiled them up in salt water and dried them in the sun. Namhlanje, 80% of the world's nations still eat insects as an important form of nutrition.
So Ntando, I'm gonna ask you a did you know question.
Right.
Mara, it's more of a you don't want to know.
Bella.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, Ntando, we already eat insects, Tina.
No,
Yes, Ntwana. In our food per year, Ntwana, ne, we eat like 450 to 900 grams of insects, and that's equivalent to like 4 slabs of chocolate.
What?
Yeah.
Yo, I don't know how I feel about that one. When I pick out Jalu to Kabangani on Facebook and on Twitter, and we will see you right after this. I need to talk to Jalu.
Sit down.
And Ned Ganjala, we're to TOMz, Sibuile Rachid, SABC, One Mzanti for sure, as we continue today's exploration in the world of entomophagy.
Yes, most definitely. So, guys, we've discovered good to see you. Usabi Ipaira, ne? Okay, cool. Nami, I have to admit, Nami, I'm not a big fan of Ipaira.
I knew it.
And if we see the thought of eating them, woo! It's even more strange, guys.
But that doesn't mean that we're not open to new things. Food, together, so Swazile Gashash, what's my benefits? I'm going from Ugu. I'm an insect. Manje again, that is Katubuti. City Uklosa, Situze, Easy Mondo Z. I just put in that.
Is this a spider? And Davua, what's up? It's your boy CADDY, pronounced Caddy. Yet on another mission, my friends. So today we're talking about entomophagy. So I'm talking to Mjita, who's gonna be my tour guide. I'm going to go to the culture and give me a whole new experience. Maybe who knows? I'm going to go to the dishes. Otherwise, it's you and me in this mission. Asam to meet Mjita. Let's go. Nda.
Nda.
How are you?
I'm good, and you?
I'm great. Are you ready for today?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay, cool. So let's get this party started. Can you tell me who you are? Where are we? And what do you do?
Okay, I am Uwane Mkiwana, and I'm from Masia Chukuseni village.
Yes.
Around Viani area.
Yes.
Then I started the bachelor degree in environmental sciences. Uh-huh. Currently, I'm working as a tourism practitioner at Tulamila local municipality.
Yes.
Where we are.
So tell me about the experiences I've seen now, and I'm clear, what's going to happen today?
Today, we're going to have a great exposure.
Yes.
All around Mopane Worms.
Okay.
And all the nutritional value that is involved around the Mopane Worms.
Yes.
We call it Mashonja in Tibetan.
Okay.
So.
Okay, and what's going to be our first step? Where are we going to go now?
Now we're going to our flea market.
Yeah.
We're going to buy the Mashonja, and we will get Mukusure and Mukushira Wuruwa and Mukushira Wamnawa and Matamatisi and Nyala, which is the ingredients that we'll use while we're cooking Mashonja.
Okay.
Here we're getting Mashonja.
Okay.
And then I've made quotation.
Okay.
Then Wambo Mashonja could have got 25 rand per cup, ne? Yeah, then.
25 rand.
Then Mashonja, about to what to combine now, the younger the season. Mostly what chirimo, which is called summer.
Okay.
Then what the areas on Gabo Palavura, Mutere. Musina, Asigonde.
Mm. And what's the difference between la Mashonja lawa na lawa?
Haya Mashonja ti amurini azwa amurini mutini. Haya aba agree.
Okay.
Richa bika aba yelo.
Okay.
Aba asina mepa.
Aba asina mepa. They don't
what's mepa? What's mepa?
It's thorns.
Thorns. Oh, okay.
Then,
okay.
Then Both this type, ne,
mm-hmm.
they derive from the same tree.
Okay.
But their difference is that when you cook that one,
yes.
they started as green.
Okay.
Then while dried, they become yellow.
Okay.
And this one, they become what? Black in color.
Okay.
But
okay.
The other difference is that this one, they've got what? Thorns.
Okay.
And that one, they don't have thorns.
The Mabani worm is part of a species of emperor moth and comes across in the warmer parts of South Africa. It forms a very important source of protein for millions of South Africans and lives mostly off the Mubani food plant. The Mubani worm first hatches from an egg in the summer and then eats from leaves in its environment. Basically, it grows as larva, which is the perfect time to eat it, before finally undergoing a transformation to become an adult moth. Once it is a moth, it can only live for 6 to 7 months. Now in this time, it lays more eggs that start the whole process over and over again.
Okay, so where is our next stop?
We're going to buy tomatoes, then matamatis, ne?
Okay.
Then we're going to add while cooking Mashonja. Yes. Then let's get onions this side.
So this is tomatoes, this is onions, this is masonge.
Yes. Now we're going to our next store where we're going to get mukusure wa buruba and mukusure wa mnawa. Those are dried veg.
Okay.
Oh, chimbrani mukusure. This is what we call mukusure. It's a dried veg.
Okay.
This one is the one that refers to as wa buruba, the flower one.
Okay.
The flower one. That vegetable that has got broad leaves, mrowatanga. Amatanga is zulu.
Tang, pumpkin.
Then we're going to buy this and the one that has got flowers.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
To match with amashonja and the tomatoes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
This one, when it's fresh, you can only cook and eat with pap.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But siyenza to preserve our vegetables. Ane aba agwele. Ma agwele, we cook some while they're green and we dry some for future purposes.
So now we've got our ingredients.
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
Now we're gonna go home and we're gonna cook it.
Yes, then at home we'll get them. I've already prepared soft pap, that is a vendor pap.
Okay.
They've also prepared the peanuts, just a half a cup of peanuts.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that actually doesn't look bad, hey?
Yeah.
Like, it's quite a feast, you know?
Don, I want to get a water, mama, funny ones. Okay, guys, funny ones, good to get a water. Tell us what you think on Facebook and on Twitter. And after the break, we're going to be discussing, what if all the insects in the world were to die?
What?
See you after the break. Welcome back to Skip and Sana Akulu Befet Lena TOMZ, the best science and technology show in the continent. Konalago channel in Itana Gakulu, SABC 1 Mzansi, for sure. If you just joined us, you haven't missed much. We're talking about insects and the science behind it.
Leo gets a visa entomophagy. Food is more than half of the Bantu. That's how I like my insects as part of their diet. Food together, we've also learned about the cultural significance of my mobani worms. Now, what if food is up here?
Yes, Befet and Spuniga Banzuguti. Actually, my insects have a lot of nutritional value.
Mm-hmm.
So which brings us to the question, Uguti, what if wonke lama insects had to die? Singabi nawo la emhlabeni. Yo, but siyam. But we'll talk about that a little bit later on the show. Kona manje, let's get back to our worms. So this is home.
Yeah, this is my home. It's called Masia Chipusini Village.
Okay, Masia Chipusini Village.
Yes, then our great chief is called Ntumeni Masia.
Okay.
Then we stay at the top mountains because we are the leaders of this community.
Oh.
So that you can see anyone who come in and out of the village.
Yes. Nda. And
No.
Okay, so manje so yenza kanjani?
Then manje we're preparing the fire.
Okay.
And then we'll start cooking everything.
Okay. Mm. Okay.
The process is simple.
Okay.
But we will separate them. We will have maybe half a hand of the dried one.
Okay.
Then we will cook the other one, mixing up with peanuts and the dried veg.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll cook the other one only with tomatoes and onions.
Okay. Mm. Okay, so what's happening?
In that bowl, then amashonja akhula manje, bayakhulisa lapha.
Akhuliswa yini amanzi?
Amanzi ukushisa.
Amanzi ukushisa.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Akhula. Zina pano ni bakoshela tanga. This is a peanut.
Okay.
These are dried peanuts. They grind them.
Oh, okay.
Ba grinder, bashumisa mtuuri.
Okay.
Ba grinder, then bazidryer, then pano ni bakoita dubi. This is the one that we use, ukodera. We call it ukodera, to mix peanuts with a vegetable. It's peanuts.
Yeah, it's peanuts. So, enjoy again. Why am I so jen? Because in Hamenu market, no, atola kona nga wavel no atole laishasin.
We don't have mpani trees around here. Then what we do is that when is the time to collect mpani worms? we get the information from the areas. We go Sanari, we change Rani, those areas. Palabura, Mutere, and so on. Then those areas, the information comes to us.
Okay.
Then the women in the village, they group themselves and hire a bike or use another lady's car. Then they travel with food, parcel, and everything, maybe for a week or for 2 weeks, mostly in summer. Then when they get there, they will start harvesting the worms. Then they will come, they will come back home with full buckets. They will come and start the process of drying them.
How long does it take
to dry?
For them to dry, yeah.
Yeah, we just sit under the tree, then you squeeze them, you take out the waste, those waste inside, then you squeeze them, then you put on the sun.
Okay, so we're ready to eat now.
Yeah, as you know, zulu zulu guys, what the mona mota mbazo anda ready no la prepare iwa. I know the machine I know that is busy. I know the mkusure, Afande machine I draw bi. Because obeki iwa. I know the alane ang obeki iwa the dried one. I know the machine I know pongo katamati is busy. Afana na ya otom. Then my papa. White hat.
Bye bye. Bye bye. Bye bye. Oh man, it was a beautiful day.
Yeah, it was a really great day.
I loved it.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for inviting us.
Yeah, you're welcome. You're welcome. It's very good to explore even our cultures because you may find out that most of our villages are not being visited.
Yes,
to hear what we're doing around and everything.
And but I'm glad to come here and experience.
Yeah, then it's an honor that you have visited us, you have explored our culture, eating with us, Mashonja and everything. Then they were all happy.
Thank you so much.
They enjoyed the day.
Bye-bye.
Okay,
sharp, sharp. Yeah. Oh man, what a beautiful day. And I was born at Bafet. I got to overcome my fear of eating amasonja. And I got exposed to different cultures. As in, Lena Sibiza and mission accomplished. What can I say? If we see it, do I pronounce carry? Is out.
Despite being generally pretty small, ama insects have tons of nutritional value. A simple cricket, for instance, contains 121 calories. A lot of that is protein and even iron. Now for Nina can pick my figure, ningazama some silkworm or a bowl of termites. Now, my insects lawa awa na ama cobs ama ningi guo, but lots of protein and calories. Now, my insects like ama caterpillar have essential vitamins, and many insects have more nutritional value than beef or fish. Of course, these critters also don't eat much, which means insect farming is more sustainable than many other types. Now, if it's speaking of little cashelastic bachelor, when a lapekaya, escorting sacro, Namangan Bako, Talipantis, Palufos, Nobele, Bole, and Joanna Lapekaya, Umay, when I'm a monu, all you have to do is simply head on over to our Facebook and Twitter pages, Lapeke, Zutola E, Tome, upload you. All you have to do is simply tag yourself, open a photo like it, or comment, Bole, and Joanna, almost up in TOMz, escorting sacro. All you have to do is simply drop us an email on toms@sabc.co.za. For now, though, let's see what's in down.
Guys, how are you guys doing? Ni grand, ni mnandi. Guys, angisho ni azguti, we have different cultures, lemzans, and we have different dishes to our cultures, angisho. Who you know?
I'm a class,
and tangu lai.
Umush.
Okay, and you?
I'm down.
And tangu lai.
And Istam.
Okay, and you?
Umzu.
Tangu lai na.
Yeah, mingko.
So guys, in Elsgut, it's very important, good sense of culture here, Tangish. And it's very important for us to embrace our culture, English. So if you guys want to learn more about your culture, good imapama dishes in Gawatlane, you guys can go to libraries, you can go on the internet and surf good see which dish is like your culture dish. And that's great, ne guys. But I'm so proud that you guys know your dishes, ne? Okay, see, as you can see, as food resources are running out, Abantu are seriously looking at insects as a solution. I don't know if it's called Pilang Amatzet and Impuan and Amapela. Otherwise, check out what's going to be happening in the future.
Itu Deniga from Canada have developed flour that is made of insects and high in protein. In Australia, an insect called Wuchetti grub has been marked for future consumption. Now, when you make it right, they say it tastes like chicken. Okay. Sting bugs are popular insects lana imzanti that could be used in successful farming practices. Plus, they don't take up that much of space and would be easier to farm more than other things. Now, my friends, we all love the idea of some insects are saying konala imklabin. Got tangsa ibuza mini day one. What if they all vanish like zwip net ganjal?
While other diseases like malaria, which are spread by insects, would be over, farmers also wouldn't have to use pesticides anymore. Kodwa, that's the only plus side. We'd no longer have plants because other insects are the ones that spread pollen so that new plants can grow. That means no vegetables, wheats, rice, or fruits. Animals like cows and chickens would also die because they have nothing to eat. We would no longer have silk or honey because zonke lezi zinto lezi zenzeka ama insects. Things would also take much longer to decompose because there are no insects to get rid of it. Imagine your leftovers sticking around for weeks. So in the end, if the world was without insects, all life on Earth would actually be gone within 50 years. Ahamba bethi TOMZ iniphathele indaba ezimnandi khona lapha emakhaya.
Injalo kayibetha lezo sinombele sithanda ukuphinza nako kufika ixesha
lokhuphisa. So wena lapha ekhaya ufune IJ episode ufuna ukuyibona khona la ku TOMZ, all you have to do is
send us the idea bafethu, and if it's fresh and brilliant we'll make it a TOMZ official episode khona la ku SABC 1.
And not only that, kalo kubetjani you get a goodie bag as well as keep us up to TOMZ
1. So wena lapha ekhaya all you have to do is send through your ideas on Facebook, which is facebook.com/TOMZ, on Twitter we are simply @TOMZ_SABC_1. Akaba bese kishile ethi la ku TOMZ silvala net kanjalo o brothers la simbonile pheka ama worms ewadla beyo kanjani vele
delicious
nami ngizavula ukutaste one day now lapha ekhaya tell us ukuthi kahle kahle what do you think of today's episode futhi nokuthi ufuna ukubonani kuma future episodes wethu TOMZ lana on Facebook and on Twitter facebook.com/TOMZ on Twitter we are simply @TOMZ_SABC_1
most definitely guys and if you want to get more information about today's episode go to our website www.tomz.co.za otherwise this is the end of the show thank you so much to SABC Education thank you so much for us here thank you so much for TOMZ ngakhohlwa ukuthi we'll be back soon
Bye. Here's what's coming up next time on TOMZ. David Mukwele is an entrepreneur at heart who decided not to let his circumstances get the better of him. So he invented a recipe that took South Africa by storm. Funa kabanzi about packaging techniques and uses. See how Acha stewed the test of time. Jumpstart your imagination with a look into the future. Get your hands on some of your very own recipes to test out at home. And it's a sad, sad notion, but what if Acha did not exist? I give my first time a contact with TMZ every Monday and Tuesday at 4 p.m. Kona lagwe SABC 1, Mzansi,
for sure.